Hey again guys, Flutter Mentor here, and in today's video, we're gonna find out how to access the value of the screen size. This will make it easier for you to create dynamic layouts for all of your apps. And to put it to practice, I made this very simple UI. The goal here is, right now this is scrollable, but by the end of the lesson, we want each of these containers to occupy exactly 50% of the available size here in this space, from here to here. So let's get to it. Again, super simple UI. I even decided to make a special custom container for this, so we wouldn't get too complicated. This is the extracted widget right here. It's not very important. You can look it over if you want, but I extracted it to make it simpler because now we'll just see this and it's not that complicated at all. The only thing we'll be changing is the container height. And now, how do we access the device's screen height? We can access such value with the help of something called MediaQuery, which is a class that will be incredibly helpful for you. It will help you make truly responsive apps, no matter what the size of the screen may be. So basically, you just type in MediaQuery.of context.size, and then you can access height or width, and there's more options, but we're focusing on these ones, specifically height, for what we want to achieve here today. And so I guess you could think that all I would have to do now that I have the height value in my power, I would just have to come here and type in screen height and then make it 50%, right? And then take this and do the same here. But if I save it, it even got slightly bigger, and if I can still scroll it, unfortunately. So it's not that simple. Now, why is this happening? Well, that's because here the screen height actually refers to the height from here all the way to here. And that's not really what we want, now is it? We need to take into account the app bar as well. And how do we go about that? Well, that's actually simpler than you would have thought. You need to remove the app bar from here and place it in a variable of its own, like so. And do not forget to actually apply it back to the build method. And now that this is a thing, we can do app bar height equals app bar dot preferred size, which is a property that comes with the app bar class, dot height. Now you know the exact height of the app bar, and that means we can come over here and use it to our advantage, like so. Screen height minus app bar height. And if we do the same thing down here, do you think this will finally work, or do you think something will go wrong? Pause the video right now and think about it. Have you thought about it? Let's see if you got it right. Kind of seems like you did, doesn't it? But the truth is, you can still scroll a little bit, and that's not the goal here at all. We want zero scroll space. That's when we know there is exact precision in our height value. And some of you might have spotted that I am not taking into account the status bar right here. And even though it's small, the truth is, this scroll space is also very small. So that's exactly what we're missing here. Now, the way to access the status bar size is also through the MediaQuery class. It's exactly the same, MediaQuery.of context, but then instead of size, you use padding. And this padding value gives you the values of the padding Flutter automatically adds around the content for typical elements like the system status bar. So here we pick .top because that's the padding being used for the status bar. More important note, this only works if you're using it within a build method that contains a scaffold, because it's a scaffold that has those padding values. So if you were to use this exact same line, for example, down here in the stateless widget that does not have a scaffold, the value of this variable would be zero. But here it's around 24, I think. But the beauty of it is that you don't even have to know the value. You just gotta come here and type in status bar height. And same here, status bar height. And don't forget to like this video if this works now. There it is. I am clicking it and it's not at all scrolling up or down. That's because we have defined the exact height of both containers to be half of the content space for both of them. And I hope you understand, we took the screen height, which is the whole screen, and subtracted it by the app bar height, and then subtracted the status bar height from that value, and then we multiplied it by 0.5 to reach the 50% value of the height of the screen from here to here. So I hope this helped you in any way or form, and if it did, please don't forget to drop a like, and subscribe to the channel if you'd like to keep on learning Flutter. So that's all for now, until the next video. This is Flutter Mentor, and out.